So the CADRE satellite is a precursor satellite to a future mission called Armada. We're going to have a large constellation of satellites that go up to low Earth orbit and study the atmosphere. So before we put the spacecraft on the rocket, there's a lot that goes into testing it in environments that are similar to the launch environment. When you have such a violent launch on top of millions of pounds of thrust, ridiculous vibrations. So we actually have a vibration table in the Space Physics Research Laboratory that allows us to shake the satellite at very high rates.
Last time we vibed, they shook loose within seconds. We made some design modifications and they lasted a little bit longer this time. We're on the right track, but we have to make a few more changes and hopefully they will survive the whole test.
We just broke during our first test here. So we're going to take it back and see if we can do a couple other quick modifications. And then if those don't work, we'll have to do a fundamental redesign.
So CADRE will be the sixth CubeSat from Michigan. The previous five CubeSats, there was Rex 1, Rex 2, M cubed 1, M cubed 2, and recently Griffix, which launched in January and just completed her mission. CADRE is no bigger than a loaf of bread, and it can pack really a scientific lab into the size of a grapefruit.
When the body panels are taken away, you can see all of our avionics with batteries, power system, a star tracker, as well as our payload called Winx, built by the Naval Research Laboratory. That has three different instruments inside that will be measuring the wind speeds in the upper ionosphere.
It's kind of a step change for us, really. We're integrating a lot of new technologies, measuring atmospheric winds at very high altitudes, ions, and neutral atoms. So all of these affect spacecraft, the electronics, and even the human body. Certainly as we move towards sending more and more people to space, we want to know what we're kind of up against. CubeSats allow us to really change the paradigm of space. Before, we were really stuck to low Earth orbit. Now we can take the previous data from the missions that we've flown and design a system that can withstand the hostile environment that is interplanetary space. So as we go to Mars, and certainly humans will be going to Mars the next 15 or 20 years. We want to be able to be really a vanguard for that endeavor.
And this is what it will look like when it's flying in space. The four deployable panels. The number of solar cells on CADRE is around 72, which is more than all of our previous solar cells and all of our spacecraft combined.
Come on in.
That's what CubeSats really allow us to do, is rapidly iterate on the design.
Get grounded.
There are all these little intricacies that pop up when you bring all the systems together. So working those out and putting out the little fires is very exciting.
If we did everything right, then this should light up. Oh, something's wrong.
The students are fantastic. They've pulled a couple all-nighters.
This is a problem.
Testing their spacecraft.
Often it's said that failure is not an option, but really failure is a fact here. When you're designing complex systems, if you're not blowing things up, then you're not really pushing the boundaries. That's really how we know when we're doing our best work, is when things aren't going perfectly and we can look at these and make it even better in the end.
There are many fuel feedstocks that are now entering both the transportation and the stationary sectors. So we hear a lot about the Canadian tar sands. You'll hear a lot in the news about bringing fracking.